In this video, I will discuss a feature specific to workers called case labels, and will explain why you need to stop using string constants and instead use case labels when defining which case of a worker's message handling loop you want to send a message to. This video will be broken up into the following parts. First, I'll present the problems with the traditional method of using string constants to define which case of a message handling loop to send a message to. I will talk about what a case label is and discuss its various parts and features. Then I will demonstrate how to create a case label by use of a Quickdrop shortcut, and then show you how to use case labels to follow the flow of your messages between message handling loop cases while developing. And finally, I'll summarize the main points that I cover in this video. So let's get started and first discuss the issues associated with using string constants to define which case of a message handling loop we want to send a message to. Let's say we have a typical LabVIEW queued message handler application consisting of a main user interface queued message handler and a secondary data acquisition queued message handler. And let's say we want to send a message from the data acquisition message handling loop to the UI message handling loop, specifically to the UI message handling loop's ready to start case. We will simply do it like this. We would use a string constant with the name of the case we want to send a message to and wire it to the enqueue message VI as shown here. Now, this is a simple and straightforward solution for applications that have few message handling loop cases and very few queued message handlers, but this method quickly runs into problems. For example, say we add another two separate data acquisition queued message handlers to our application, and they too want to send a message to the UI message handling loop's ready to start case. Then each queued message handler needs to contain the same ready to start string constant. In fact, there may be several other places in our code that also contain the same ready to start string constant. If we decide in the future to change the name of our UI message handling loops case to ready to start acquisition, then we would need to manually search for every ready to start string constant and change the text in it. In addition, it is very easy to misspell a string constant like I have done here. These mistakes often go unnoticed and can result in errors that you might only discover during runtime. So these are some of the main problems of using string constants to define which case of a message handling loop you want to send a message to. They are difficult to track, making your code harder to maintain, they aren't tied specifically to any queued message handler, and misspelled strings can introduce unnoticed runtime errors into your code. Like the LabVIEW queued message handler, workers also use strings to select the case of a message handling loop's case structure, but Workers aims to improve upon these problems by replacing string constants with case labels. So what exactly is a case label? A case label is simply a single string that is wrapped in a VI that corresponds to a particular case of a worker's message handling loop. To demonstrate case labels, again, I'll be using the worker's version of the continuous measurement and logging sample project. So please feel free to follow along with this tutorial if you wish to do so. Let's start by opening up the main VI of the UI worker and looking at the start value change case of its event handling loop. In this case, we can see that there is a case label called c_start.vi. Case labels are VIs that have icons that are reduced in size, contain a pink bar at the bottom, and above the pink bar contain the header of a worker. And the case label's label is visible, which is the VI's file name. If we double-click on the case label's icon, the case label's front panel appears, and we can see a single string indicator containing the string start. And we can see two important bits of information here. Firstly, the case label's icon tells us that this case label is a member of the UI worker, and thus corresponds to one of its message handling loop cases. Every case label belongs to a worker and thus takes the icon header of that worker. And the string indicator here contains the string start, meaning that this case label corresponds to a message handling loop's case named start. So together, these two bits of information tell us that this case label corresponds to the start case of the UI worker. If I open the case label's block diagram, you can see that there is nothing on the block diagram apart from the output string indicator. Now let's have a look where this case label lies in the project. You can see that the case label exists in the UI worker under a virtual folder called case labels. And this is why the case labels icon takes the header of the worker, because it is a member of the UI worker. And you will also notice that every case label has the prefix C underscore in its file name. This simply lets you know that this VI is being used as a case label. Another feature that case labels provide over string constants is the ability to set their scope, just like you can any VI in a worker. For those of you who are not familiar with this feature, the red key you see over the case label icons in the Project Explorer mean that these case labels are of private scope and can only be used within VIs that are members of the same worker. Being able to set the scope of a case label is a very useful feature, allowing you to choose which case labels can be used by external workers and which cannot. To set a case label scope, simply right-click over it, select Access Scope, and there you have the option to set different scopes for the case label. It is also possible to keep track of where a particular case label is used throughout your code by use of LabVIEW's Find All Instances feature, which allows us to find all the places in our code that send a message to a particular message handling loop case. To demonstrate how to find all the places where a case label is used in your code, let's double-click on the UI Worker's Update Status case label to show its front panel, right-click on its icon, and select Find All Instances. And you can see that there are four usages of this case label in different places throughout your code. And if we double-click on each instance, we can see all the enqueue locations in our code that will send a message to the UI Worker's Update Status case. And lastly, if we ever wanted to change a message handling loop's case name, we would only have to also change the string located in the string indicator of the case label to the new name. Then right-clicking on the indicator and selecting Make Current Value Default. And don't forget to rename the case label to reflect the updated case name, and that's all there is to it. Workers provide you with a simple way to create case labels for any of your workers' message handling loop cases by use of a Quickdrop shortcut. To demonstrate this, you need to have the block diagram open of any of your workers' main VIs. So to demonstrate this, let's create a case label for our acquisition worker. But first, let's take a look at which case labels already exist in this worker. Under its case labels folder, we can see that the acquisition worker already contains four case labels. So let's create another one. Let's jump into the block diagram of the acquisition worker's main VI and create a new case. Let's call this case my new case. Okay, now with this case visible, activate the Quickdrop shortcut. Press Control Space to bring up the Quickdrop dialog box, and then press Control and the number 9 key. And a dialog will appear asking you to confirm if you want to create a case label called My New Case. Select OK. And then after a few seconds, another dialog will appear saying the case label has been created successfully and has been added to your worker. Press OK. Now, if we have a look in our project, we can see that we have a new case label called My New Case, and its scope is by default public. So that's how you can quickly create case labels for all of your message handling loop cases in your workers. Another feature that case labels provide you with is the ability to use them to jump from a message's enqueue point to its dequeue point to help you save time following the flow of messages around your code while you develop. To demonstrate this, let's open up the main VI of the UI worker and go to its block diagram. Let's start with the stop value change case of the event handling loop, and let's follow the queue data starting from this case. Select the UI worker's stop case label by clicking on it, and then activate the Quickdrop shortcut, Control Space, and then Control and the number 8 key. And you should see the stop case appear in the worker's message handling loop below. And now in this case, we can see that two messages are sent. One to the acquisition worker's stop case, and another to the logging worker's stop case. So to jump to the acquisition worker's stop case, select the acquisition worker's case label, activate the Quickdrop shortcut, Control Space, Control and the number 8 key, and the acquisition worker's stop case appears. And now in this case, a message is sent to the UI worker's acquisition stop case. Let's jump to that case by again selecting the case label, activating the Quickdrop shortcut, and the UI workers acquisition stop case appears. We can continue following the flow of messages, but let's stop here. So Quickdrop shortcut Control and the number 8 key is a very useful feature that case labels have to help you follow the flow of messages around your application. So to summarize the contents of this video, a case label is simply a single string wrapped in a VI that corresponds to a particular case in a worker's message handling loop. And these are used in place of string constants when you want to define which case of a message handling loop to send a message to. Unlike string constants, case labels can be scoped, helping you control which cases of a message handling loop can be called by external workers and which cannot. It is easy to search for all instances of a case label used throughout your code by right-clicking on a case label's icon and selecting Find All Instances. If you ever want to change a message handling loop's case name, you only have to change it also in one other location, the string output indicator of the corresponding case label, and not in many places throughout your code as you would have to if you used string constants. A case label has an icon, and this icon takes the header of the worker it belongs to, allowing you to identify which worker a message should be sent to. Quickdrop shortcut, Control and the number 9 key automatically creates a case label for whatever case is currently visible on a worker's main VI's block diagram. And Quickdrop shortcut, Control and the number 8 key will jump you to the case that the selected case label on the block diagram corresponds to, helping you easily follow the flow of your messages around your application while you develop. So I hope this video has convinced you of all the advantages that case labels bring over string constants, and that you will benefit from using them in your future workers projects. And if you would like to learn more about workers, there are several resources available, such as the official workers user guide, detailed help for the workers API, commented sample projects, and of course, the tutorial video series of which this video is part of. And these are all available either through LabVIEW once you have installed Workers, through the VI Package Manager, or directly on the official Workers website.